Russian President Vladimir Putin arrives in North Korea for his first visit in 24 years. Putin was greeted by North Korean leader Kim Jong-un at a welcoming ceremony in Pyongyang. Putin has vowed to deepen trade and security ties with the nuclear-armed state and to support it against the United States. Washington and its Asian allies are trying to work out just how far that support will go.
The deepening cooperation between Russia and the DPRK is something that should be of concern, especially to anyone that's interested in maintaining peace and stability on the Korean Peninsula, but also supporting the people of Ukraine as they continue to fight against Russian aggression. And so, of course, you know, you're well aware of DPRK providing ammunition and weapons to Russia that's been able to help them perpetuate their illegal and unprovoked war against the Ukrainian people. So it's something that we're going to continue to keep an eye on.
The United States working to cancel restrictions and arms deliveries to Israel. That's according to Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who says the assurance was given by U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken during his recent visit.
When Secretary Blinken was recently here in Israel, we had a candid conversation. I said I deeply appreciated the support the U.S. has given Israel from the beginning of the war. But I also said something else. I said it's inconceivable that in the past few months, the administration has been withholding weapons and ammunition to Israel. Secretary Blinken assured me that the administration is working day and night to remove these bottlenecks. I certainly hope that's the case. It should be the case.
U.S. President Joe Biden warned in April the U.S. would stop supplying weapons if Israel forces make a major invasion of Rafah. Washington also paused a shipment of bombs to Israel in May due to concerns over the impact they could have in densely populated areas. U.S. President Joe Biden announces a new effort to provide a path to citizenship to hundreds of thousands of illegal immigrants who are married to American citizens. The new program will be open to an estimated 500,000 spouses who have lived in the U.S. for at least 10 years. Some 50,000 children under age 21 with a U.S. citizen parent will also be eligible.
They've been living in the United States for at least 10 years. These couples have been raising families, sending their kids to church and school, paying taxes, contributing to our country for 10 years or more. Matter of fact, the average time they've spent here is 23 years, the people we're affecting today. But living in the United States all this time with this fear and uncertainty, we can fix that. And that's what I'm going to do today. Fix it.
The U.S. already provides a path to citizenship for immigrants who are married to Americans and enter the country legally on a visa. But in most cases, those who enter illegally must first leave the U.S. for years before being allowed to return legally. Now, Thailand becomes the first Southeast Asian nation to recognize marriage equality. The country's Senate approved a bill Tuesday that legalizes same-sex marriage. The law will still need royal approval and will come into force 120 days after its publication. The measure changes references in marriage laws to gender-neutral terms. It also gives same-sex couples the same rights when it comes to adoption and inheritance. Advocates called the move a monumental step forward. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
We begin in New York City, where 27-year-old Filipino Judd Sansón, who has been labeled as a suspected jihadist by local media, appeared before Judge Edwin Avillo at the Queens Criminal Court on Monday. The Hollis, Queens resident was arraigned last Thursday on charges of criminal possession of a weapon, among other charges. Police officers arrested Sansón in a traffic stop last Wednesday and was caught heavily armed with dangerous weapons in his 2013 Black Ford Explorer with obscured license plates. Sansón is being held without bail at Rikers Island. Sansón's public defender objected to the presence of local media during the court proceeding.
I believe if the general public sees my client's face plastered in the press with allegations that have yet to be proven, that they will unfairly come to a conclusion prior to hearing any evidence in the matter.
A grand jury will determine if there is enough evidence to bring Sansón's criminal charges to trial, and if so determined, Sansón will be back in court on July 9th. Let's go to British Columbia in Canada, where organizers of the Pinoy Festival Alliance have been hard at work putting the finishing touches on what is expected to be a huge gathering of Filipinos in British Columbia this Saturday, June 22nd. Hataw Zumbayanan by Pinoy Pride Society will kick off the day-long festivities dubbed Panahon Na Para Magsaya 2. Over 70 organizations and vendors are participating in Pinoy Festival 2024, which is part of the Filipino Heritage Month celebrations in the city of Burnaby. The festival will feature a parade of Filipino organizations, followed by cultural performances, art, fun, and games for kids, a grand Santa Cruzan with local beauty queens, and a TFC Hour headlined by the Philippine Concert King, Martin Yavera.
In one day, everyone's a Filipino. We'll see the Philippines all at Swangard Stadium, right here in the heart of the Lower Mainland at Swangard Stadium.
The world needs you to become something more.
And finally, in entertainment news, in Ultraman Rising, Christopher Sean plays Ken Sato, a cocky Japanese-American baseball superstar who was called to become a superhero when giant creatures, or kaiju, started attacking Tokyo. In this latest animated film, now streaming on Netflix, the reluctant superhero also unexpectedly becomes a father figure to a baby kaiju. Ilocana Okinawan Tamlin Tumita voices Ken's mom, Emiko, a trailblazer in Asian representation since her breakout role in the original Karate Kid movies. The Hollywood actress celebrates the film's achievements.
Ultraman Rising is the achievement of a wonderful American writer team, you know, Shannon Tindall and Mark Haynes, to bring about a classically Japanese story, but really kind of Americanize it, which to me means with Netflix muscle, it's shared with the world.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.